Well, this is Jim Mitchell, and we're back for another episode of the Libertarian Censored Podcast. Let's get into it. RFK had a very interesting tweet today, which happened to contain numbers 14 and 88 in it. If you believe that the man, who has been going on an embarrassing I Love Israel tour, was sending a secret message to neo-Nazis, you are an incredibly stupid person. From Dave Smith on Twitter, and I posted that. And I said, people really look for dog whistles everywhere these days, you know. You know, I have some problems with RFK. As Smith knows, he's up Israel's ass like all the rest of them. But, you know, as people really do just look for dog whistles everywhere these days, you know. 1488, you know, they're just numbers, you know. People really, really, really look for a dog whistle anywhere. That just gets the thing, you know. And they look for anything to say, oh, I'm right and you're a Nazi. We have Elon Musk's Twitter bans ad showing Republican interrupting coupling bedroom. Free speech for me, not for thee. The true meaning of supreme individual liberty, according to Elon from theindependent.co.uk by ChiTown20. And, yeah, I would agree that's a bit heavy-handed. I don't know what the full deals are. It was just he took off the ad entirely, or if it's just stopped it from getting money. But, you know, I definitely think, you know, it's just kind of a bad look for him. But, you know, that's Elon's not no stranger to getting bad looks, so, you know, I think he'll deal with it, so, you know, yeah, that's my thoughts there. Research shows that small government is efficient government. For my circle jerk, and that's a post from the Cato.org, and I would agree. I personally don't want efficient government. I want inefficient government like we kind of have currently, because, you know, if small government's efficient, I think it'll be more effective. And an effective government is, I would say, not libertarian, because that's trying to enforce stuff on you, and I don't think the government should be enforcing stuff on people. Then we have studies keep finding that social media algorithms don't increase polarization. Why is the press so skeptical? From Reason.com, and I posted that, and I said, it's because the press is the one who really increases polarization. You know, a lot of polarization right now comes from the media in particular, and they'll never call themselves out on it. So that's why they would look at studies like this and they say, oh, we're not going to emphasize those because the media is the one who's really calling out, is really pushing polarization, but they'll never call themselves out on it. And that's sadly, they'll sadly get away with it. But I think, you know, so hopefully with the rise of alternative media, I think where people are starting to wise up. And I think soon, I think at the very least by the end of the century, what we know as the mainstream media today will hopefully all be gone. Next we have, the UK government is very close to eroding encryption worldwide. And, yeah, it's scary, you know. Winter Rain, the close by Winter Rain from EFF.org. And Winter Rain commented, this is what happens when you elect conservatives. And I like what Bobby McGrath says here, anti-privacy bills and the be bipartisan. I said, agreed, there is both an authoritarian left and right on the political compass for a reason. So, you know, the UK may have a conservative government, but both the authoritarian left and the authoritarian right have shown that they are very against encryption and internet freedom, especially when it goes against the narrative. Look at the Twitter files or the Facebook files or China's social credit system, for instance. Then we have LOL, in about 15 hours from this tweet, Bernie Sanders voted against a special inspector general audit of $117 billion in Ukraine war money / contractors from Lee Fang on Twitter, and I posted that, and I said, important to remember that tweets are not legislation, and virtually like this isn't legislation either. And I posted a tweet from @McGill's on Twitter, and it's Greg Caesar had a 9-hour photo op hunger strike. So that's, you know, it's mostly virtue signaling what people do on social media. They don't really care about people; they just want a virtue signal. And yeah, and Rand Paul voted against it too because he didn't want another office. But the thing is that Sanders' reasoning isn't. He's not using Paul's reasoning. He just doesn't want to hold the Pentagon accountable, even though he says he was on social media and through like Twitter and Facebook, but he doesn't really want to do it. He's just he's just virtue signaling. He doesn't. If he wanted to do it, he could easily do it, but he doesn't want to do it. Watching RFK go on this apology tour for Israel is really something. That dude isn't afraid of the FBI, the CIA, or Big Pharma, but Israel, he's absolutely terrified. And that's from Clint Russell on Twitter, and I posted that, and I said, RFK Sr. was a big Israel shill as well. Big reason the Palestinian was the one to assassinate him. Then we have, she's the executive director of Gen Z for Change, which used to be called TikTok for Biden, and they've been to the White House multiple times to meet with Biden, even Barack Obama. KGP knows exactly who she is, and of course allowed her to speak. From Nuance Pro on Twitter, I posted that, and I said, we live in a world where almost nothing is organic. It's important to remember that, you know, there's tons of shell groups that are very astroturfed, like this Gen Z for Change, that's one of them. And it's important to remember that everyone thinks that everything's so organic these days, but I would say we live in a time where nothing's been less organic than ever before. So that's my thoughts there. You know, it's very unorganic time comes to discourse. And we have Rolling Stone editor at Noah Schachtman, who was a colleague of Meek's, rewrote a story by one of his journalists to remove all references to child sexual abuse and deliberately made the false suggestion that the raid had been related to Meek's work as a journalist, from Michael Mouse on Twitter. I posted that, and that's about how the guy who wrote Pizzagate was busted for child sex exploitation. You know, it's really like, I guess Pizzagate might have been all projection on his part. Just go show how corrupt the world is and how those in position of power and influence let it be so. So, you know, the thing is, the journalist class, they say, oh, we are the bearers of truth. We speak truth to power. When in reality, they're just as corrupt as everyone else. And they'll try and hide it, but you know, people are catching on. They're just trying to push an agenda, and they're as corrupt as everyone else. That's why you should trust whoever you want, because everyone has an agenda, and they all want to shove it at you. Then we have, if Hillary was an officer, it would still be 93 degrees today in Georgia, but I'd be limited on how cold I could set my thermostat or how much gas I could use to cook my food, from Hannah Cox on Twitter, and I posted that. And I said, hopefully Congress would stop her, but executive orders are really overpowered these days. People here would say that it wouldn't happen, but it would be the first line justifying stuff like that, like it in the event of a declared climate emergency, see how they reacted to COVID. The biggest regret of my life was believing the media hype and voting for Hillary and Biden. I'd still put them over Trump and RCV since he is somehow more insufferable than them, but they would definitely both be very low since they are the same authoritarian tyrants. And, yeah, so that's my thoughts there. You know, the thing is that it's I think the climate emergency is mostly just media hype, but if the TV ever says climate emergency, we're gonna have officers of the law go door to door to turn off to make sure everyone has their air conditioners off. You know, a lot of people would be justifying it because the media would say so. And now you have this social media, which creates this idea of, oh, my ideas are always right because I always find people to agree with me. And that's horrible. As you can see what we did with COVID, it would happen again with the climate emergency, and that's not good. Then we have, this also applies to some libertarians, how Russian colonialism took the Western anti-imperialist left for a ride, from Salon.com by Legio X. And I agree, you got some grifters in there, but you know, you have to understand, what about American neo-imperialism as well? And a lot of people who say that, who talk about how bad Russia and China are, also ignore the fact that the United States is very neo-imperialist as well, and that's important to note. Because, you know, the U.S. is Russia and China are bad, but the U.S., despite supposedly being a more democratic country, is really just not much better. For everyone working hard to keep up with the state of government healthcare in Canada these days, from Scott Horton on Twitter, I posted that, and he linked to a Daily Mail article. So it was, trans Indigenous Canadian slams doctors for denying euthanasia requests, from Daily Mail. And I said, damned if you do, damned if you don't there. They fulfill her desire, and the headline is, government kills transgender person. They don't, and it's transgender person is allowed to suffer. Y'all want freedom from government, but can't live without it, from self-post from Beige Forever. And There probably would be a lot a bit more, so I would agree there. Let's see what he says. There are some snowflakes who create societies in rural islands. There are those who rail against government encroachment over onto individual autonomy, but don't have the wherewithal to see lady riches out here. We all need each other. We are the government. So let's give you and fix the power-ridden worlds ahead. Why? So I kind of agree to an extent. I probably do need other people to survive to some extent, because I'm not the best, you know, I'm autistic. But, you know, the thing is that other people will always find a way to screw me over as long as we're around each other. So that's what I've learned. People always find a way to screw you over. And so that's why I don't really trust other people. And that's why I think even if I'd be worse off under a system of a decentralized government or even no government, I'd still take it because I don't really like what we have currently. It leads to more society where people can't trust each other, and that's something that I really don't care for. Then we have capitalist authoritarian Stooge Alito says Congress has no authority to police Supreme Court ethics from WAPO, from Washington Post, from Chi-Town 20. And I guess you can make the case. I don't really care, you know. The governments are all, they say there's checks and balances, but none of them are ever going to be held accountable. Not Congress, not Supreme Court, not the presidency. We just got to get rid of it, start anew. That's my opinion. You know, let's see. MAGA reporter asks MAGA Nazi, what do globalists and rhinos? MAGA Nazi says, kill them all. MAGA reporter replies, I agree with you. From that's a cross post from the conservative terrorism subreddit. Probably, that's right, from Dragon 20, it's probably feds, I would say. Yeah. You know, it's all probably feds whenever stuff like that happens. How a lot of people feel right now from, Dragon 20 across was from the TikTok cringe subreddit when Biden Nazi's running in, and it sees the guy being depressed, yeah. The thing is that, everyone's just kind of depressed because that we have these couple of presidential elections have all been insufferable people, so we just gotta move on from that. And you can't let the idiot in the White House dictate your life. Just ignore them. You know, that's probably what they deserve. Just let them sit in just obscurity. Just stop giving them attention. That's my opinion there. Democrats take back control of Michigan and start moving to Detroit to a more libertarian science-influenced tax system, considers shift from property to land value taxation from taxpolicy.org from Chi-Town 20. I guess you can make that argument, yeah, but I think Michigan, you know, they're increasingly saying, oh, we're going to take your guns, we're going to take we're going to have a narco-tyranny, stuff like that, you know, so I don't really trust them. And they're also on the new misgendering bill, which definitely goes against free speech, I would say. For the first time in history, Americans are doing worse than their parents. An American born in 1940 had a 90% chance of earning more than their parents. A millennial born in 1984 is only 50% chance from Freds.net. That's from Proton 13. And I said, I blame the Federal Reserve. The thing is that, you know, it's central banking that's really doing this. The long-term effects of it. And that's why we need to get rid of it as soon as possible. Florida schools, okay use of curriculum. By Perjure You, and I created a right-wing nonprofit from PNJ.com by Whittling Dan. And I said, Whittling Dan said, I thought Republicans were against indoctrination school. I said they just want to control the schools so they can push their agenda like the Dems do currently. It's why I'm against the idea of the school. It's mostly just a pretext to push an agenda on people. The left completed an ideological march on through the institutions. It's why schools tend to be bastions of progressive. Now you increasingly see stuff like drag queen story at them. Everyone's to control the institutions so they can control the people. I think we need to get rid of the institutions as I view them as inherently collectivist and authoritarian. Because, you know, they all just want to push agendas at you. I think we just got to get rid of the institutions. If people want to have their own institutions, they should be able to do so, but they shouldn't force them on other people. Like, right now we have them forcing other people with the idea of public school and all that. I think we got to get rid of all the school and just have, if people want to educate other people, they should be able to, but I think the idea of right now of we're sending people to school to be educated by people who've been trained by the government to do so isn't the correct answer. The Minneapolis Police, a criminal organization from Big Joel on YouTube, and that's by Skilled Cosmicist. And I would agree the police aren't really that nice, you know. You know, they just enforce the law, you know. They can declare whatever they want to be a law or a crime, and that's something I don't really care for. Every 4 years on Election Day, if the other side wins, then America will be destroyed. Then it becomes, well, America's already been destroyed, from Michael Mouse on Twitter. I said, everyone always wants to find a reason to be worried about something, especially in regards to politics. It reminds me a lot of the South Park episode over the 2008 election, where all the McCain fans think it's the end of the world, and the Obama fans are celebrating, and Obama and McCain are really just on the same team for their jewel heist, and fair, frankly, everyone's distracted, you know? It's just, everyone's like, oh, it's the end of the world, my party lost. Well, really, they're all just on the same team, you know? They're just shaking hands in the back room, so it doesn't really matter. It's just all theater. That's all it is. It's all, politics is pretty much all theater. Libertarian Party of NH goes full mask off, 14 words from Twitter.com by Tom Furchan, and that they tweeted, we must secure the existence of our people in the future for libertarian children. And I said, it's a typical LPNH ship post. You're reading too much into it. LPNH's entire goal is being edgy. I don't personally care for it, but it's what they do. They want woke progressives jacking off and saying, look how bad they are. And Andrew Croxton replied, you're probably not wrong, but assuming you're a non-bigoted person that's in power, you see the party represented this way. The vast majority of people aren't terminally long-term voters like the rest of us, just because we're against the people who say libertarians should be Republicans. I said, I agree, but that's how life is sometimes. You can't control what everyone else in your party is doing. That's just how life is. Sometimes you're going to disagree with other people in your party, and that's how it is. Then we have, there are polls, are less libertarian intensive votes, the 2024 Republican Party U.S. primary, July 30, 2023 edition. And, let's see, Chris Christie has 3 votes, Vivek Ramaswamy has 1 vote, Donald Trump has 1 vote, and Vivek Ramaswamy has 2 votes, and Chris Christie has 3 votes, Vivek Ramaswamy has 2 votes, Donald Trump has 1 vote, other explaining comments has 2 votes. So yeah, so I'm saying sticking with Ramaswamy. And Jimmy Silverhand replied, the guy wants to make voting contingent on federal service military similar, but interesting to see where some focus on dissolving federal government association installation. I'll say it's not that easy, it's not that he's good. It's that all the other front runners are worse. Suarez is good as well, but he's not as much as his front runner. Then we have full large libertarian censored votes. 2024 Libertarian Party U.S. primary. Let's see. So right now we have Chase Oliver has 2 votes, Mike Termat has 1 vote, and other explaining comments has 4 votes. So let's see. I vote for Termat. He follows me on X, and also I met him in person at one of my LP County meetings. So let's see. Then we have the Democratic Party primary, and I said, sticking Floyd, since I'm still talking about RM State Jr. So then the current thing is, three votes for Doug Zock, 2 votes for Mary Williamson, 2 votes for Joe Biden, 1 vote for RFK Jr., and 2 votes for other explaining comments. Okay, so let's move on to, the city of San Francisco has launched a massive safety investigation into Yad Elon Musk for erecting an Exxon's building. The same city just dropped all charges against men who stole a car driving through a pedestrian walkway over a cliff and crashed into the sidewalk below, from Benny Johnson on Twitter. And I posted that and I said, laws only apply to who the government wants to apply them to. And Ninja Lover said, my office discharged the case because more investigation is required to properly charge this case. And I said, they have them on video doing it, and so they clearly just, that's clearly just a cop-out. It's narco-tyranny. Certain people are allowed to get away with anything, but others are just held to the fullest extent of the law, you know, because it's like Kyle Rittenhouse, you know. The people were allowed, the left was allowed to riot in Kenosha, but if Kyle Rittenhouse tries to defend himself, then suddenly he's being charged. Just goes to show you, it's a double standard legal system that we increasingly see getting more prevalent. We have the Facebook files part 2. Newly subpoenaed documents reveal Facebook bowed to the Biden White House's pressure to remove posts from Jim Jordan on Twitter. I posted that. I said, Jim Jordan has some problems, but this and the Twitter files should definitely concern you. I won't be surprised if the government was also pressuring other sites like Reddit and remove content that went against the agenda. And I also said, When we get here, don't be say you weren't warned. I linked a tweet from Wall Street Silver who tweeted, China's social credit score experiment gains momentum. Now, first, if a low rating calls you, your phone emits a siren instead of the usual ringtone, that then there is a voice reminder that a conversation with a subscriber will lead to a decrease in your credit score. So I think that's coming to the U.S. soon. And secondhand politics, commented Kay. I said government pushing for censorship is not Kay, but apparently a lot of people these days think it is when it goes with the narrative enough. Then we have Barbie and accidentally anti-woke masterpiece from Shoe on Head. And I posted that. And I said, saw the looks of the folks today. It definitely struck me as relying on the tired mid-2010s feminism that really should be starting to die out by now. People wonder why guys like Andrew Tate, he shit too, are getting so popular right now, and stuff like this is a big reason. Also, I don't say U.S. culture changed more of the course of 2014-16. It has really changed since. And on another side note, screw patriarchy and matriarchy, what we need is decentralization. Another fault I had, even if HRC won the 2016 election, would still likely have the same exact sexism everywhere culture. It's why we still have this racism everywhere culture, even though Obama won the 2008 and 2012 elections. So I think we're going to wrap it up there, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.